Okie dokie. In this video, we are taking a look at Next.js internationalization routing with GraphCMS. This code is available on the GraphCMS examples repo over on GitHub. This example demonstrates how to use Next.js internationalized routing with localized GraphCMS content. I'm going to download this manually with npx digit, copy that command, and I'll paste it into my terminal and wait for it to download. CD into the project directory and open up VS Code. Before we take a look at the project, I'm going to install the dependencies with yarn. And while that's installing, we'll take a look around the project here. In our Next.js config file, we have our internationalization defined with our locales for English and German. The default locale is set to English. In our lib folder here, we're defining our GraphQL client with GraphQL request. In the index file here, we're rendering out the products in a pre-tag. We're using getStaticProps here to get our index page query for the locale. We've got the ID, name, and slug, with the locale being passed in here, and returning the props for products. Go back up to the index page here. This is where the products have been passed in. If we go over to our ID slug here, we're using a GraphQL language tag from GraphQL request. We're importing our GraphCMS client from our lib. And again, we're rendering out a pre-tag. Let's take a look at getStaticPaths. Here we're defining our paths array with the structure in the products ID here. In our for of loop, we're spreading in the paths and the products. We're mapping over those to match them up to the product ID and locale. And we're returning the paths here. In our getStaticProps, we're using the params and the locale. We're then destructuring our product for our GraphCMS client request here. And we're taking in the locale to be used in our product page query. Okay, let's take a look at this in action now. I'm going to run yarn dev and go to localhost 3000. And here we have our pre-tag being rendered out. If I go to one of the IDs for the English locale, we have our product being rendered out here. If I do the same for German, we get a null because we don't have any locale set up in our GraphCMS e-commerce project. So I'm going to go over to the project here, go over to the content and the product. And then for the long sleeve T, I'm going to go over to the localizations over in the side panel here, add a localization for German, and add in the translation for long sleeve T2. I'll save and publish this for both locales, save and publish. I'll go over to localhost 3000 now, hit refresh. We have our translation here on our localized route. That's it for this one. I hope you found it useful, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.